My name is Joanna Sulich. I'm a biologist.
I live in Longyearbyen, and I'm taking part in the research project investigating the maternity denning of polar bears. We are placing cameras in front of polar bear dens, and this gives us an opportunity to observe what happens when the polar bear mothers and their cubs emerge from the den for the very first time. Svalbard is an archipelago which is lying very far north in the Arctic, but at the same time it is placed right by the very warm ocean current that comes from the south. And the rate of climate warming here in Svalbard is twice as fast as any other areas this far north. So it gives us a really unique opportunity to see what climate change and environmental changes mean for polar bears. When deploying cameras, we go to a given location either by helicopter or by snowmobiles, but we're leaving machines in a safe distance in order not to disturb the polar bear family. We then set up the camera, we add the solar panel to it so the batteries are continuously charged in times of good weather. We add additional camera traps that are monitoring the area by taking pictures in addition to video. And then we leave the area as fast as we can, hoping to get really good footage when the cameras are being picked up. My role is analyzing the data that we retrieve from the field, and that really opens a window into seeing how bears behave, what's their condition, what's their reproduction status, and how well they're doing in raising their young, about how playful they are and what this first moments of childhood outside of the den looks like. But also we can gain a deeper insight into environmental effects on this part of polar bear's life. Sometimes what's really striking is that when you go through footage, you get day after day, or like picture after picture, video after video of very harsh weather. The wind is howling, the snow is accumulating even on the lens, but then the sun hits or it becomes a little better, and then suddenly you see a head popping out, and then another and another, and you realize that this kind of home of howling winds and blizzards is somebody's cradle. And this is the environment when future generations of bears are being raised in. That perspective, it's truly mind-blowing.